I'm Patty Seidel, and I'm a graduate student at Tiffin University. Today, I am sharing a presentation of the process theory for English 515, Teaching College English. My hope is that you will have a better understanding of the theory, and it will help you decide what part of the theory you can take away to help make your students better writers. Historically, the process theory came about because of the growing research that the way teachers were teaching writing was not working. The teaching of grammar was having little or no effect on student writing growth, so from this research, the process theory was born, beginning in the 1950s. In the 1970s, a group of teachers began to share their writing, comparing how professional writers create with how students were taught in school to write. In 1971, Janet Emig's research launched the theory's use in the classroom. Donald Murray furthered the theory by asserting that teachers needed to assess the process that students go through to write rather than the end piece of writing. The writing process theory is designed for students to better understand and grow through the process of writing rather than just assessing a final product. The processes of writing include pre-writing, drafting, and rewriting or revision. A student may go through this process many times while writing a single piece. Donald Murray describes the specifics of each step in the process theory in his article, Teach Writing as a Process, Not Product. He believes that pre-writing is the most important stage of the writing process. However, he later asserts there is not one process, but many. The process varies with the personality or cognitive style of the writer, the experience of the writer, and the nature of the writing task. An important concept of the writing process theory is that students are given a non-threatening environment in which to work. Murray states that the students must have an atmosphere of freedom where teachers are coaches, encouragers, developers, creators of environment in which students can experience the writing process for themselves. The process theory methods encourage teachers to concentrate on the process rather than the end product that is produced by students. Student writing becomes the reading of the class and aids in the learning of the students to better their writing skills. This requires collaboration with peers and sharing of student work in a non-threatening environment. Another important aspect of the process theory classroom is the evaluation of the entire work of the student from beginning of the piece to the end. Teachers must consider the entire process that students go through to produce a piece in order to really understand and evaluate that piece. This is where portfolios become an important assessment. Perhaps the most important part of utilizing process methods in a classroom is that it helps students discover their own voices. They can choose topics and feel as though they have important things to say. Students must learn to write through doing, not discussing the process. Let them write. Some key terms to remember when discussing the process theory are pre-writing, writing, and rewriting. Peer writing groups are very important for this theory to work, and this classroom is student-led with the instructor as facilitator, where writing workshops are an important aspect. Portfolios work as teachers can see the process from the beginning to the end. Rubrics and graphic organizers must be available and utilized in this classroom. Teachers can check for student understanding and growth through formative and summative assessments throughout the process. Janet Emig and Donald Murray are perhaps two of the most important figures in the researching and writing about the process theory. James Britton is also a key figure. These key figures help teachers understand that teaching writing was more than teaching grammar and mimicking what other writers produced. They help teachers understand how to allow students to go through a process that would lead to learning to become writers. Other important figures involved in this theory are Peter Elbow, Donald Graves, and Mina Shaughnessy. Their research has had powerful influences in the theory and classroom application. There have been many who have helped develop the writing process that is recognized in most curriculum writing standards. Assignments that are important for the process theory to be successful are portfolios in which students can include all their writing processes from invention to the final draft. It is important for students to have rubrics so they understand what the evaluator is evaluating, and the evaluator needs to stick closely to the rubric when assessing the writing. There should be graphic organizer lessons developed and a variety of organizers available for the students to utilize in the classroom. There needs to be some sort of writer's workshop environment and peer writing groups that allow students to share their writing. Students can practice methods such as free writing and chunking during instructional time to help them choose topics and create coherent work. Assessment methods can include both formative and summative assessments, rubrics to guide and evaluate, evaluation of the entire process through the grading of portfolios, peer evaluation for both writer and peer, publishing of writing, use of graphic organizers, and participation in class are all types of assessments that can be used. Assessments can include mini-lesson evaluations. Oftentimes, mini-lessons are a component of the writer's workshop classroom. In these mini-lessons, teachers can focus on areas in which an individual, group, or whole class struggles. The mini-lessons can be approached individually or in groups. The lessons can then be assessed in many different ways, both formatively and summatively. The process theory has become part of teaching of writing into the 21st century. Almost all English teachers include the writing process as part of their curriculum. This theory allows teachers to use pedagogical strategies that get students to write and express themselves, gaining confidence in their writing as well. Seeing writing as a process helps students understand that producing fine literature does not happen in a 20-minute span. I would like to thank you for viewing my presentation of the process theory. The sources used in the making of the presentation are scholarly sources that come from experts in their field. The trickiest part of studying the theories is extracting the things from each theory that will best build skills to make students that we teach strong writers and thinkers. I hope that this information helps you add to your arsenal of teaching strategies. Thank you.